Key tutorial number 1, defining lambda, lesson 9. In this lesson, you will learn how to add formal comments to your key definition in order to nicely document it. The generated document can be then used for various purposes, to ease understanding the key definition, to publish it, to send it to others, and so on. The key tool allows a literate programming style where the executable language definition can be documented by means of annotations. Some backends of the key tool, such as those enabled with the --latex, --pdf, and the --html options to the compile tool, know how to interpret such annotations. There are three types of comments, which we'll discuss next. Ordinary comments. These use // or /*, */, like in various programming languages. These comments are completely ignored. Document annotations. Use the at symbol right after // or /* in order for the comment to be considered an annotation and thus be processed by the key tool when it generates documentation. As an example, we can go ahead and add such an annotation at the beginning of the Lambda module, explaining how we define the syntax of this language. Note that we can simply use any LaTeX commands, including sections, subsections, mathematical symbols, and so on. Once we are done typing the annotations, we can compile lambda.k with a document generation option, say --pdf, and take a look at the generated PDF document. Other options are also possible, for example --html and --latex. The latter is particularly useful when you want to incorporate documentation generated by the key tool into your papers. Feel free to experiment with these options. Header annotations. Use the bang symbol right after // or /* if you want the comment to be considered a header annotation, that is, one which goes before begin document in the generated LaTeX. You typically need header annotations to include macros or to define a title, as an example, let us set a LaTeX length and then add a title and an author to this key definition. Compile the documentation and take a look at the results. Notice the title. Let us now add loads of annotations. Okay, let's see what we've got. Depending on your PDF viewer, you may also see a nice clickable table of contents with all the sections of your document. This could be quite convenient when you define large languages because it helps you jump to any part of the semantics. Tutorial 1 is now complete. The next tutorial will take us through the definition of a simple imperative language and will expose us to more features of the K framework and the K tool.